After downloading the PDCAT for Windows software to your computer's hard drive, you can find it in the program menu. Once selected, the PDCAT software opens with a title screen and a start button. Click the start button to begin the assessment. Enter an identification number for the child or youth being assessed. This ID number can be any combination of numbers and/or letters. You will use this number to identify this particular child for the current assessment and all future PDCAT assessments. Then, select Start to continue. On the next screen, you will select the domains: daily activities, mobility, social cognitive, and/or responsibility, and the type of PDCAT, speedy or content balanced, that you will be using for the assessment. You may select one or more domains each time you conduct an assessment. Select Next to continue. Complete the demographic information on the next screen by selecting the respondent's language for administration, either English or Spanish, and the child's gender. Choose the child's date of birth by clicking on the arrows in the calendar provided for the month, day, and year. Select the type of walking device and wheelchair if applicable. If a walking device is selected, the PDCAT will include items specific to walking aids in the mobility domain. If a manual wheelchair is selected, the respondent will be asked if the child is able to propel a manual wheelchair. If this question is answered yes, the PDCAT will include items specific to manual wheelchair use for a separate short scale within the mobility domain. Then select Next to continue. The first domain chosen for administration will appear next. An introductory statement which instructs the respondent on how to complete the PDCAT is provided. One item is presented on the screen. Items in the daily activities, mobility, and social cognitive domains ask about how much difficulty the child has with specific activities. Select a response for the item by clicking on the circle next to one of the five response options. Then click on the Next button to advance to the next item. A response must be provided for each item, or the PDCAT will not let the respondent advance to the next screen. In addition, there is a previous button that may be used if the respondent would like to go back to a previous item. Here's an example of an item from the eating and mealtime content area of the daily activities domain. This is an example of an item from the home tasks content area of the daily activities domain. Here's an example of an item from the getting dressed content area of the daily activities domain. If more than one domain was chosen for administration, a new domain title screen will be presented, followed by items for that domain. Scores will be presented only when all selected domains have been completed. This is the first item used to start the mobility domain. It is from the standing and walking content area. This is an example of a mobility item from the wheelchair content area. This example of a mobility device item comes from the standing and walking content area. This is an example of a mobility item from the running and playing content area. The title screen for the social cognitive domain alerts respondents that there aren't illustrations for this section. This is an example of an item from the everyday cognition content area. This item comes from the communication content area of the social cognitive domain. This is an example of an item from the interaction content area. This item comes from the self-management content area. The responsibility domain uses a little different format than the other three domains. There are no pictures, and the response options are different. Respondents are asked how much responsibility their children take for specific activities. There are five response options. This item is from the organization and planning content area. This example is from the organization and planning content area. This item comes from the health management content area. This item comes from the staying safe content area. When all domains have been completed, a screen will appear that will ask who completed the assessment. If the parent or other caregiver response is chosen, the assessment results will be saved and the program will close. If clinician is chosen, the respondent will be asked which score report is desired. Score reports are available for each assessment date and for each domain administered. Score reports can be viewed on the computer screen, printed, or exported to the user's computer. They can be accessed at any time from the computer's program menu by selecting PDCAT Reports and entering the ID number. A few different score reports are available. A summary report provides the date of assessment, the domains that were administered, scaled scores for each domain administered, normative scores in two formats, a T-score, and age percentile range. In addition, the summary report also contains the number of items which were administered for each domain and the type of PDCAT which was administered. The clinician can select a range of dates so that several assessments for one child can be displayed on one page in the summary report. The other option is to select a detailed assessment report. This is an example of a PDCAT detailed assessment report. As you can see, it includes general demographic information as well as scaled and normative scores for all of the domains tested. It provides some of the same information as the summary report, including the date of assessment and the number of items administered per domain. In addition, this report provides a list of all items and responses for each domain administered. If a content-balanced PDCAT was completed, the option for an item map can also be selected. This is an example of an item map, which contains all of the items in the specified domain. Scores for each of the administered items are marked with a red box. The red line indicates the scaled score, and the gray shaded area on either side of the red line indicate the standard error band. The item map shows the level of difficulty for the rating scale points for each item along the scale. Additional information about the PDCAT can be found on this website.